So yesterday we have seen like you know how to work with font styles and all right, how to change the style of the font, like color of the font or maybe italic, bold or underline, things like that, right? And again, so all this whatever we have done till now, we worked with individual cells inside, right? So we have taken one by one cell by its address. Like address nothing but row number and column number. By specifying the cell address, we access particular cell and then we deal with the individual cell. Maybe reading the data from it or working with the font styles, working with the background color, how to change the background color and all. So all these things we have seen as of now in the Excel. And now what we do is we will discuss on something called range. Okay, and see, so far, what's the range here is, so far, we worked with individual cell. At a time, we were accessing one by one cell, and then we were retrieving or doing the formats, all this. But when you say range of range here, so range is nothing but sometimes what I want is, instead of, changing the background color or changing the font or anything, whatever, in individual cell, what I want is, I want to change the background color of entire range, whatever is used. The entire range, whatever is used, you call it as user range. Okay? So the selection is called as user range. So I want to change the background color of entire range. Then how do you do that? Okay? So just wait for some time, before we go into the script. Or I want to change the font color for that entire range, whatever has been used. Or I want to change the font style, all those. Okay? One requirement is I want to change for entire range. Or another requirement for me is I don't want to change for entire range or not for one cell. What I want is I will give the range like this. The range is now from B2 to C3. That's what you say here, that range. So now sometimes you might be having some customized ranges. So now what I want is here, I want to change the background color of that selected range, not entire user range and not for an individual cell. For the selection, whatever the selection that we have made, for that selection I have to change the background color. How do we do that? That's another requirement for me. Maybe change the font color or background color, all those. So that's just a formatting. But other part, what I want is maybe I want to whatever the range that I have, I've selected here, I want to copy that data from this sheet to maybe I want to copy this data to some other sheet. So when we are copying, what we are doing, we are selecting, sorry, one range here, and we are copying that. And we are coming to the next sheet, and then we are specifying the cell. Okay, we are giving the start range here, nothing but we select the cell and we just paste here. So that means copying and pasting the data from one sheet to another sheet. Maybe when you want to copy entire data. You want to copy entire data, or you may need to copy a particular range. Okay, the selected range or an individual cell you may need to copy, anything, whatever it is. But how do you copy the data from one sheet to another sheet? That's also a question. Okay, then today we will see all these things, how normally we work with the ranges. Okay, then to work with the ranges, anyway, first thing is you have to initiate the Excel object. So first you say OXL equals to create object, then you say Excel dot application, then set OWorkbook equals to OXL dot workbooks dot open, then you say OXL, sorry, str file path. We provide the path here. Okay, so before execution, we will update that path. Workbook start open. str file path. Then I have to specify the sheet from which sheet I need to select the range. Or first, okay, we will deal with changing the format of the font in a particular range. Okay, so then we will discuss about how to copy the data and pasting it. So first, what I do is where I need to deal with here. So in the sheet file, there is a workbook dot worksheets of. You specify the sheet name here. So this will select the sheet, whatever the sheet that you want to work with. Then what I want to do is, my first requirement is I want to change the background color of entire range, whatever has been used. Okay. So how do you change the? First thing is, if you want to change the background color of entire range, whatever has been used, first you need to access that range. So how do you access the range which is used? Say worksheet dot user range. Worksheet dot user range, in a sense, the range which has been used in that particular sheet, whatever the sheet that you have selected. Then take that range into a variable. So set orange, because user range also will be written as an object type here. User range will be written as an object type. So that's the reason I'm using set here. Set orange equals to that sheet dot user range. Okay. So orange will be the range which has been used completely. Now I want to change the background color of that range, whatever the range that I have selected here. Then to change the background color of a cell, what did we do? Okay, that sheet dot cells of interior dot back color, right? But now when you want to change the background color for particular cell, we said cells dot particular cell dot back interior. But if you want to change the background color for entire range, then what you do? Give that range. Instead of using cell, you say that orange. Orange is nothing but that entire range. Orange dot interior dot color equal to VB blue, something that I am giving you here. I am giving blue color. Then once you do that, you save this, then you close this and then you quit from application. Then now you change to I'll just say it as working with the user range. Then open this folder where this script has been saved, and then run this. Okay, this is for, yeah, we have to give the file. So this is the lessons. Say str file path equals to give the path of the file, whatever the file that you want to access now. Okay, working with user range. Open this. Now you can see the entire range of data has been changed. So why it has changed for entire range, not for a particular cell? Reason, because we have selected user range here. User range means that entire range which has been used. Okay. Same thing. Now, if you want to change the font color for entire range, if you want to change the font color for entire range, then what you do is say orange dot font dot color equal to, I'll say VB white. I'm changing to white color. font color has been
changed.
Similarly, you can also do that over a font color dot, sorry, not font color, you can say font dot size equal to, maybe you can set it to 20, something like that. Then range dot font dot underline equal to true, dot bold equal to true. You can do anything whatever you want. Okay, so this is how you select entire range and then you can deal with the formatting and all. Forget about copying the data, then we'll come back to the copying again. Okay, we'll come back to copying again. Right? So this is working with user range. So you can select the entire range and then you can change the background colors, font styles, all those things can be changed in entire range. Okay, next. Now I don't want for entire range which has been used. So now I will change only from certain thing. Okay, so the data has been started from B2, that means B stands for second column here, 2 stands for row, and BT2 C3, that means third column, third row. So second column, second row to third column, third row, only that range I need to modify. Now I don't want, when you say user range, the entire range which has been used will be selected. Okay, but if you say if your requirement is not entire range, only customized range from this column to this column, this row to this row, that's it I want. Okay, so that means this is customized range, not the user range. So in such cases, then you cannot use user range. You cannot use user range here. Then what else we can use? Just let me copy this entire code here to the next file and do this. You should not say user range. The reason why you can't say that, because I don't want to work with entire range which has been used. But with what we have to work, I need to work with customized range here. So if you want to access the customized range of cells, okay, then what you do, you should not use user range, then you say this range dot range. But which range it is? You have to specify the address starting to ending. Then from where to where I want, from B2 to C3. Then what you do is here B2, that is the starting point, starting cell comma ending cell. So when it comes to the range here, when you are specifying range, remember in the range cell address has to be specified like A1, A2, A3 or B1, B2, B3, something like that. B is a column and number is a row there. Okay, when you say second row, second column, you have to say like B2, especially in the range. It's not like you can say 2, 2, second row, second column. You have to say like B2. Okay, only for range objects, it is like that. Then, say B2, comma, from where I want? From C3. So it will select the range, whatever is mentioned in the address. So it will select from B2 to C3. Then it is equivalent to this, from B2 to this is C2, this is C3. So that is the range that we are asking to select, starting from B2. This is called B2. If you look at the address bar here, you can see that this is C3. Okay, so from B2 to C3 I want to select. Then remaining things, I need the same thing, but I will change the color of it. Change the color of it. I'll say instead of BB blue, I'll say BB white is the background color, BB white, and BB blue or BB red or anything. I'll say BB red is a font color. Just run this and open that now. See, only that change. I also changed the font style, and also, like, you know, I changed the font size to 16 or 20 something, and 20. I underlined it, and also I changed the font color and background color as well. So this time you can see that it's not one cell or it is not entire range. So this is customized range. So why it has selected, why it has updated only for these cells? Because when I mentioned here range, so I have given the range from B2 to C3. Okay. So first one is from, second one is to. This is what range object means for. So if you want to select only particular range of data, then you say that sheet dot range of, you mention the starting cell and ending cell. Okay, starting cell and ending cell. So this is how we work with user range and normal range object. So difference between range and user range is, user range is entire cell, sorry, entire range, whatever range has been used in a particular sheet, and range in the sense you have to specify the address from which range to which range that you want to select on the, okay. But if you don't give ending point is optional. If you don't give ending point, what will happen? It will select only that cell as a range. Okay. So if you don't give end point here, it will select only that particular cell as a range. One cell will be treated as a range. That cell is here B2. Okay. So this is what selecting the range object, a particular range of the data. If you want to select, you can use this. Okay. Now what I want is here, you know, I want to copy the data from one sheet to another sheet. So I may need to copy entire data. I may need to copy entire data from sheet to sheet. Okay. Then what I'll do is, let me change this format to back again. Okay, so manually I'm doing it. Okay, I'm just changing the format. Now what I want is, I want to copy the entire data, whatever the data has been used, I want to copy entire data here, entire data here, and then I want to paste the data in sheet 4. And when we are doing it the same manually, if you are copying the data from one cell to another cell, then how you do it manually? First, in the source, from which sheet you want to copy, you have to select the range, whatever the data that you want to copy, you have to select that range, and in the destination, wherever you want to paste it, you don't need to select the complete range here, right? You don't need to select complete range, but what you do, you have to select the starting point, that's it. You have to select the starting point, and then you paste it here. Depends on how many cells and how many rows you have copied, it will be pasted from the starting point, that whatever you have selected. So in the destination, again you specify the range here. In the source, you have to specify the range and you copy it. In the destination, you don't need to specify the from row to end row in the destination. What you do in the destination, what you have to specify is, you just have to specify the starting cell. That's it. Okay, so you select this cell, paste here. So when you paste in this cell, it's not like entire data will be pasted in one cell. Depends on number of cells and number of columns and rows copied. Then this is the starting point. From here, it will paste all these rows and columns. Getting what I'm saying here? So that's how normally we do. So in the destination, what you need to do is, you don't need to specify starting and ending point. In the destination, you just specify only starting point here. If you specify starting point, from there it will start pasting. So how many rows and columns will be pasted depends on how many rows and columns you have copied. Okay, got what I'm saying here? Okay, now how you can do this using script? Let's see. This is the file, and since what's our requirement is? Our requirement is to copy entire data, right? Copy entire data. So that's the reason what I'm doing is range, I'm specifying it as user range. Then you can say O range dot, what should I do? Copy. So if you want to copy that entire range, you just say first you specify it as user range, because entire data has to be copied. So after selecting the entire range, user range, then I am copying it. Then what you do is next, where you have to copy, sorry, where you have to paste it, you have to paste it in sheet 4, another sheet that you have to paste. So in another sheet you have to paste it. I am saying O sheet 2, I mean a different sheet, or O destination sheet, anything, any variable name it is, okay, it can be. Then you can say o workbook dot worksheets of sheet 4, workbook dot worksheets of sheet 4. So what does it mean? You are selecting sheet 4 here. Then again you have to specify the range there, in which range you have to paste it. But when you are selecting the range here in the destination, as I told you, don't need to give the complete address starting and ending. You just give the only first cell address enough in the destination. Then I am saying O destination range equal to O sheet 2 dot range of, from where you want to paste it, I will specify it as B3. That means start pasting from B3 column. That means second column, third row. Okay, third row it is. So start pasting from second column, third row. So you don't need to give the destination here. You don't need to give complete destination. Then what you do is O destination range dot paste special. It's not paste, it's a paste special you use. That means, okay, select that particular range. You are selecting, when you say range here, it will select that particular cell, whatever the cell that you have given. After selecting that cell, it will go and paste there in that cell. So when you paste the data in that cell, then it's not like entire data will be pasted inside that cell only. From there, it will start pasting. It depends on number of rows and number of columns. Then what we have done exactly is, first, okay, we have selected the user range of one sheet and we have copied the user range. That means entire data will be copied when you select user range, when you copy user range. Then in the destination, again, we have selected a different sheet in the destination, and we have selected the starting cell from where it has to paste. You don't need to specify the end point here. You just specify only start point in the destination. Then you paste it there. Okay, that destination dot paste special. The reason why we use paste special is, when you are pasting it, okay, when you are pasting it, there are different formats that you can paste. Okay, so I'm not sure if you have observed or not, some of the, in certain situations, when you paste this, you will get the options like, to paste it in different formats. You want to keep it in source format, or you want to keep it in a destination format, or you want to paste it as an image. You get different formats like that. And then when you use paste special, you can also specify that by providing the numbers. Each format type has got one number. Paste special 1, it will paste it in one format. Paste special 2, it may paste it in different format, like that. Okay, so when you use paste special, you can ask to paste it in different style if you want. Okay, but that is not necessary for now, as of now. Okay, we will see that later part whenever the situation demands. It will overwrite. If the destination has got some data already, it will overwrite. That's what happens in when you do copy and paste. Right? Okay, it will always overwrite. Then what you do is next. After pasting it, I'm just saving that workbook and then I'm closing that workbook. Then copy, paste of user range. Then sorry, Excel file is already has been opened, right? So that's the reason it is giving that error message. Okay. So there is a problem. Earlier it was not closed properly. Just wait. You can see the data has been pasted. So the reason, because earlier after opening that Excel, we workbook.close was not executed, so it was locked actually, so that's why it did not do properly. Run it, open it now. Now you can see data has been pasted. Why it is pasting only, why it is pasted here, why not from beginning? Because we selected B3, and if you do it, if you give like A1 here, A1 means start pasting from first cell onwards. Now you have some data already there in the cells, right? Let's see what will happen. What happened here? Overwritten. That's it. So the entire range is pasted. If there is any data already in any of the cell, whatever has come in that range, the data has been overwritten. It will overwrite it. Okay. So this is this is how you copy the entire data from one sheet to another sheet. And also, if you want, paste it in a different workbook, not in the same file. I want to open a different file, and then if you want to paste it in a different file, you can still do that. See, what I'm doing is sheet 5 and sheet 4 both are in same file, same workbook. So that I'm pasting, right? But you can also do it for different workbook as well. Okay. So then what you can do is here, what you can do is you can create a new workbook. Workbooks.add. So OWV1 is nothing but a new workbook. Then destination range, what you can do is what I'm doing now. OSheet2 is nothing but sheet 1 of new file, whatever we have added. So it's a different workbook completely we have selected. So what you can do is you can paste within the same file and in different sheets, or you can paste the data within the same sheet, or you can paste the data in a different workbook as well. You can copy the data from one workbook to another workbook, nothing but another file as well. But only thing is, you have to open two files here. Okay, so one is the source file and second one is a destination file that you need to create. So you can say destination file dot worksheets of any worksheet that you can select, and then you can do the paste special there. Similarly, you can also copy the sheets also from one, instead of selecting one range and then copying sheet itself, you can copy or you can move it. But again, as I told, we will see such kind of things slowly, because that will not give in the reality we don't use them much, okay, copying the sheet and all. But slowly, anyway, when you are learning interview point of view, that's a little bit important as well. Okay, So this is how you copy the data from one sheet to another sheet, and what you are doing here, you have copied entire range and then you just pasted. You have you selected a destination here and then you pasted there. So that's what it is. You need to close that WB1. You have to save it. I did not save it, but you have to save it and then you need to close it. Okay? But I just did not do that here, but you have to do. Okay? Fine. Same thing now. If you want to copy, I don't want to copy entire data. What I want is, I want to copy the data only from here to here into sheet 1. How do we do that?
Range.
So we say range here. Range of B3, comma D5. Then range.copy, and then you select the destination there and you paste it. Got? So this is how we work with the ranges. So sometimes, you know, it's not all the time we work with individual cell there. If you want to access individual cell, you say that cells of row number, comma, column number you specify. But if you want to work with the range, then you don't need to, you should access the range here. How do you access the range? Then you say you have two things, user range or range. User range means the complete range which has been used. Range means you have to specify the address, row number and column number. You have to specify the address. Okay. So that's what it is. Okay. Now what we need to do is, let me take a different example again. So let me have sheet 1 here. Okay. I'll say test case ID. Test case ID I will provide here. And then I'll say username, password, and first name. Some columns I'm using. Last. There's a problem with the username, password, first name, and you say last name. And something called EMPID, things like that, some of the columns that I have here. Then I'll say TC001 and enter some data here, but I'm just entering some junk data, no problem. I'll say TC002. Okay, assume just I have 3 test cases placed in this sheet 1. Now what I want is, okay, what I want is, first I need to know where the test case, I will give one test case ID there. Maybe TC001 or TC002, some test case ID I will give in the script. And my script has to find where the test case ID is. Where the test case ID is. Then, wherever the test case ID is, it has to copy entire row. Wherever the test case is, it has to copy entire row, take a different sheet, paste. Okay, so that means only the row where the test case is, it has to copy it and paste it in a different cell, entire row. Now when you are pasting the row, if you have copied entire row and pasting it in the destination, what you have to do is, you have to select the first column always. When you are copying entire row in the destination, you must have to copy, you must have to select only first column, but any row it can be. If you want to paste here in the third row, then you have to select the third row, first column. you should not select second column or third column or fourth column. Okay, so cursor, you have to select the first column of specific row wherever you want to paste, and then you paste it. So entire row has been pasted here. But if you don't select first column, if you select the second column or third column, that will not be pasted because it has selected entire row, right? All the columns have been selected. So when you paste from here, some of the columns will be less. Some of the columns will be less in that row here in the destination. That's the reason it will not be able to paste it. So whenever you copy a row, entire row, then in the destination what you have to do is you must have to select column A only all the time, but row can be anything, depends on in which row you want to paste. If you want to paste it in first row, you have to specify it as A1 destination. If you want to paste it in second row, you have to specify the destination as A2. Third row, A3, 4, 5, A4, like that. Okay. So what I have to do now is, first I need to search for the test case. I provide the test case ID. Then I need to search where that particular test case is, in which row the test case is. And then I have to copy that entire row. And then I need to paste that entire row in. Next. Sheet. Okay. Maybe the data is there in sheet 1, I need to paste it in sheet 2. Okay, so let's see now. I'm just copying this file path and Excel initiation everything. Then where this, your test case are? Test case are in sheet 1, right? Okay, I will give the test case ID here, str tcid equals to, I'll give tc003 or 004, any test case whatever it is. Okay, now just for now assume that test case is in test case ID is in third row or fourth row. For now, just assume we hard code the row number as it is in fourth row. Okay, later we have to remove that hard coding because it's not only the fourth row all the time. Before this test case, somebody may introduce one more test case so that this test case may come down again. So it may not be fourth row all the time, but for time being, we are hard coding the row number. But in the reality, you should not do that. Okay. Now, how you select the entire row is, the logic is like this. You have to specify the row number, which row you want to select, and you can specify the column number, anything, but in that row. Okay? So what you can do is, you can keep the cursor in the third column of fourth row. And if you say entire row dot select, it will copy the entire row. So that means if you want to select a row, cursor has to be in the same row, which row you want to copy, but it can be in any column of that particular row. So that means, okay, if you want to select fourth row, cursor has to be in the fourth row, in any column. So cursor can be in first column of fourth row, second column of fourth row, or fifth column of fourth row, tenth column of fourth row. It can be anywhere, no problem. Okay? So, because we are not selecting the column there, we are selecting the row. So, wherever the cursor is, okay, in which row the cursor is, go to that row and select the entire row. You don't need to think about the column there, which column that you want to select. Cursor can be in any column, but mandatorily it has to be in the row, which row you want to copy. So, that is the reason what I am doing is here, okay. I'm just saying OC dot cells of 4, 1. That means fourth row, first column. Row number is important here, not the column number. column number can be anything. You can give 4, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4, anything that you can provide here. But row number is important because you are copying the row, not the column. Okay, got what I'm saying here? So after selecting that cell, okay, in a row, that cell dot something called entire row. That means wherever that cell is, select the entire row, depends on the cell address I have specified here. So row number is important. What is the row that I have given here? Row I have given as 4. So it will copy entire row. I mean, it's not like copy here. We are not given copy method yet. But it will select the entire row, depends on the cell there. So entire row is nothing but the 4th row here. Dot copy. Entire row dot copy. So which means that copy the entire row wherever this cell is. Then next what you need to do is you need to select the destination. As I told, you know, the destination starting must be first column. Starting should be A. But row number can be anything, depends on in which row you want to paste in the destination. If you want to paste it in first row, you have to specify destination as A1. If you want to paste it in second row, you have to specify destination as A2. Like that. Then set O destination sheet equals to O workbook dot O workbook dot worksheets of sheet 2. What happened? Okay. Now set O range equals to O destination sheet dot cells, sorry, range of give as
A1.
Give as A1. Okay, so that means you are selecting A1 here. So you are setting the range. A is nothing but the first column that you are specifying. Then O range dot test special. This is important here. Okay, then save the workbook. Then you close the workbook and then close the application. Quit from application. Copy error. Okay, then let me close this. You can see that has been copied, right? So entire row has been copied. Then if you specify (1, 1, 2) like that, then what does it mean? Copy the first row, and then in the destination I'm giving it as A2. That means paste it in second row in the destination. You can see first row has been copied and pasted it in second row in the destination. So this is how you can copy entire range sorry, not entire row. Okay, so you can copy a range, or you can copy an individual cell, or you can copy a particular row also. Same thing. Now what I want is, I want to copy a column. So I want to copy the column here. Okay, it depends on the column header, but you know, anyway we hard code the column number, but we already saw that how to get the column number based on the header automatically yesterday or day before yesterday. We have seen that program already, right? Okay, so but now what I want is, depends on the column that I provide here, it has to copy the entire column. Now when you are copying the entire column, the cell address can be like this. It has to be, now I want to copy third column, right? So the cursor has to be, or you have to select the cell from third column in any row. You can keep the cursor here as well, but here the column number matters, not the row number. So what is the column here? In which column that cursor is now? It is under C column. That means it is a third column. Or you can keep anywhere, no problem. But which column you have selected is a matter here. Then you can say that cell dot whatever the cell that cursor is now, cell dot entire column. Okay, so for the row we have given entire row, for column you say entire column dot copy. Now when you are pasting it in the destination, anywhere, wherever, whatever the destination it is, what you have to do is, cursor has to be in the first row. When you are pasting entire row, cursor has to be in the first column, but when you are pasting entire column, cursor has to be in the first row. Then if you want to paste it under second column, then keep the cursor in B1. If you want to keep the cursor in first column, keep it as A1. So possibility is like this in the destination: A1, B1, C1, you know, D1, like that. But only first row, column can be anything there. You can't give A2. That means you can't select the second row. You cannot paste it from second row when you have selected entire column. Okay, similarly for row, when you copy entire row, then where, while pasting, column must be A only. You cannot give B column or C column or anything when you copy entire row. Okay, so just something like this. When you copy entire row, cursor must be in A column, and while pasting it, when you select entire column, then cursor must be in first row in the destination always. Okay, so that means it has to be here or here or here or here, like this, anywhere it can be, but it cannot be from second row onwards. So what I am doing is here, okay, let me copy this and let me create a new file here. Okay, now what I am doing is, instead of copying entire, so column matters here, 1, 3, that means what is the column number I have given here? Third column. You don't need to think of the row number here. It can be first row, second row, third row, fourth row, wherever it is, it can be, but column matters because we are trying to copy the column. Then you can say entire column dot copy. Copy entire column, and in the destination, I am giving the destination as C3, and as I told, it has to be in the first row, and column can be anything. So I am saying C1. That means that paste it in C column or D1, E1, okay, F1, anything that you can provide here. Then close this, execute this. And then come to the sheet 3. You can see the entire column has been copied. This is the column that which has been copied. You can see that entire column is pasted. Okay, so like this, what you can do is, whenever you are copying the data, so there are different ways that you can do. You can copy entire sheet, or you can copy only the range of the data, and entire user range you can copy, or particular range you can copy, or particular cell also you can copy. Also you can copy entire row and you can copy entire column. All these are different possibilities in the copy of data. Okay, now what I need is here, I may need to delete the data sometimes. Now assume that, okay, in the sheet 1, come back to the sheet 1, then maybe TC2 has been removed now. Okay, so that TC2 has been removed, it is not required anymore. So what I have to do now is, if I want to delete TC2, how can you do that? You have to select that entire row and then you need to delete it. So how do we do that? Right click and you delete it. So like this normally we do it, but you have to select the entire row and then you delete it. Or if you want to delete entire column, then you right click and then you can say delete. Okay, so like this. Then how do you delete the row? It's very simple. So anyway, you are saying entire row, right? Entire row, and I said 3, 1. Row number matters here. What I said here, 3, 1, that means third row. So column doesn't matter. It can be first column, second column, third column, or anything. No issues, because we are selecting entire row. So if it is in the first column also, it will select entire row. If it is in second column also, it will select entire row, or it can be anywhere, no problem. Then you say entire row dot delete. Okay. Then over book dot save. Oh, I'm saying the third row. Which is third row? This is the third row. So it has to delete TC2 here. I'm just closing it. And then workbook dot close. And then you can say OXL dot quit. Deleting a row. And run it. See, it has been deleted. Entire row has been deleted. So it's it. You can't get back it. It will be deleted permanently. Now, if you want to delete entire column, simple. You can say entire, which column it will delete now? First column, because the column number says as 1, so that it will select the first column. Depends on the column number you provide. Column number matters here when you say entire column. Then let's see whether the first column will be deleted or not. Delete a column. See here, first column has been deleted. The TCID was a first column, so first column has been deleted. So like this you can do many things there. You can copy a cell, you can copy a range, or you can copy a complete range, you can copy a sheet, or you can copy a entire row, or you can copy a column, a particular column, or you can delete the range, or you can delete the row, or you can delete the column. Anything that you can do it. Okay, now so what I want to do is next. Okay, so this is how normally you work with, and you can say that entire row dot interior dot color you can use, entire row dot font dot color, like that you can still use that. That means if you want to change the background color of entire row, you can say that entire row dot interior dot background color. So it will select entire row and background color will be set to that row. Okay, fine. So next few things that what I want is, maybe you know there are some individual sheets are available. Probably I may need to delete the sheet. Okay, I may need to delete any sheet here. So first, okay, what I have to do is I need to know how many sheets are there in this particular workbook, and then I need to get the count of. I need to get how many sheets are there. I need to get the name of each and every sheet, and then if there is a sheet which I have given, I mean maybe I will give one sheet name here. If there is any sheet available with the given name, I may need to delete that particular sheet. Okay, but I don't know whether that sheet is there or not. But I have to see whether that sheet is available. If the sheet is available, and then I need to delete it. Okay, then so we don't have any direct method to delete it. But what I have to do is first I need to access the. You have to write the logic here. Logic will be like this: first get the count of the sheets, get one by one sheet name, and compare that sheet name with your expected sheet name. If any sheet name is matching with that, then you delete it and then you have to save it. That's the logic. Okay, in this logic, first thing that what we have what's the first point here? First get the count of the sheets. How many sheets are there in the workbook? And then you have to get the name of each and every sheet. So we'll go with step by step now. So what I'm doing is I'm just selecting the workbook here. Right. Okay. I've just selected the workbook. Then. I have to get total number of sheets, right? I am using the variable called total sheets equals to o workbook dot worksheets dot, you have a method called count. Okay. So it will give total number of sheets available. Then I'll say here Mrs. Box total. Then for I equals to 1 to total sheets, for I equals to 1 to total sheets, then what I need to do is I need to get one by one sheet. How do you do that? O workbook dot worksheets of I, nothing but I will be starting from 1. Worksheets of 1 means first sheet. Workbooks of 2 means second sheet. Workbooks of 3 means third sheet, like that. Okay, so I value is representing the sheet number here. So you can select the sheets by using the number also. We have I already told that, right? So you can say worksheets of 1, worksheets of 2, worksheets of 3, 4, like that, depends on which sheet you want to access. So you are selecting a particular sheet and then getting the name. It sheet dot name means it will retrieve the name of the sheet. This is false. Sheet dot. Excel dot. This is worksheets dot count. Then if you want to get to see, first one is sheet 5, sheet 4, so it is giving one by one sheet here. Okay, next if you want to delete a particular sheet here, then what you do is if stair sheet name equals to sheet 1 and if dot delete, you can say exit for. Arguing the same, right? No, it is deleting, but the thing is here, we are not saving that. Okay, we are not saving it. So if you don't save that, it will close without saving it. So the old one is being coming back. Did I save this? Output dot save. Deleting, right? Don't write on this. Close this Excel. Still not deleting. Okay, I'll check this again. Okay. It's supposed to be deleted, but somehow it is not deleting. I'll just check it. But that's a method only. But I need to check why it is not being deleted. Okay. So you can also delete the sheet like this. That's, you just say that sheet dot delete, that's it. Worksheets of so and so sheet dot delete. Okay. So that's how normally you can also delete the sheet, but somehow it is not working. You can just write down that. Okay. So that's a script that we use. I'll just check it offline and then I will let you know. No, you can't do that. You can't do that. That's not a range you call it as. No, you can't do that. It's not possible. You can't do that. Okay, so you can't select that randomly. Okay, so you have to select a range. Range means it's from this column to this column or this row to this row. That's it. Okay, so you can't select randomly or cross or all this.
Okay, so now
this is how normally we can get the count of the sheets, and then we can delete a particular sheet also. Okay, and then if you want to move the sheets, okay, so now if you say that sheet 5 has to move to end, don't write down this as well. Set O sheet equals to O workbook dot worksheets of say sheet 5, then O sheet dot move O workbook dot worksheets of sheet. Just don't write on this, don't write on this. Sometimes you can see the sheet has been moved before that particular sheet. So it's always before the sheet. Okay. So this is how normally you can also move the sheet if you want. You can just access a particular sheet, you can say that sheet dot move, that sheet dot delete, that sheet dot move, or that sheet dot copy. You can also copy the sheet and then you can paste it in different workbook also, no problem. Okay, sheet dot copy, all these things can be done. This is how you work with the sheet, like moving, deleting, or copying, all this. But this may not be that much important, but just it's a kind of interview point of view, that's it, nothing else. Okay, so this is something, you know, we work with the data. We'll stop here today, and tomorrow just some basic things that we need to know, like I said, borders, or creating some hyperlinks, or writing some formula, or sorting the data. Okay, so you have to sort the data and that. So okay.